What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. We're still doing the teams that were eliminated from the Stanley Cup Playoffs. We're still doing it in a different format. I was on vacation, as you can tell, until obviously the Avalanche beat the Edmonton Oilers, but I was on vacation, so I wasn't able to do much. So now I am back from my little vacation, and we're going to go through some of these rapid fire. I'll get these up as fast as I can. I want to get these out at least before the Cup Final. So let's start with the Los Angeles Kings. The LA Kings had quite an interesting season. I don't think anyone expected them to make the playoffs, or at least the majority didn't. I certainly didn't, but I liked the direction they were going in. I thought that the rebuild was taking good strides, but I still thought that it was going to take a while before they became playoff contenders again. So I was pleasantly surprised, and I think a lot of LA fans would agree with me, in the strides that the team took this past year. And I think there is a lot of hope for the future. I know it sucks losing to the Edmonton Oilers in the first round when you thought you had the pieces to go make a deep run. You weren't able to get it done. But in my opinion, that they should not be discouraged by this year. This was, by every measure, I would say, a successful campaign for the Kings. They took strides in player development. Their youth is now flourishing in the lineup. I think they finally have the heir to Jonathan Quick with Cal Peterson in net. I trust their coaching staff. And the drafting is paying major dividends for the LA Kings. Quentin Byfield's, of course, the main example, but he's not the only one. I think that what the LA Kings are doing is they are building the path back to contending. Now, obviously, it's going to be difficult to get there, especially in the Western Conference, which is incredibly stacked. You have teams like, obviously, the Colorado Avalanche, who are still have age on their side, as they have now advanced to the Cup Final. You still have St. Louis. They don't look like they're going away anytime soon. Minnesota has some young talent. Edmonton, obviously, looks to be much stronger than many anticipated. Calgary still has a good amount of their team there. And not to mention, there are some teams that I think in the West, in a few years, if a few things can go their way, will find their way to the playoffs as well. The Western Conference looks like it's going to be an absolute bloodbath, but I trust the Kings will be one of the stronger teams in the middle of all of it. So what I do like is that even though their youth is certainly starting to build a future core, I still think some of the veterans that they have can still help bring this young team along. Big example, I think, is Jonathan Quick. I think Cal Peterson's the future of the franchise in net, and he looks to be the perfect heir to Quick. He looks like he's taken a lot of strides. Obviously, Cal Peterson will be 28 by the start of next year, but I think they'll still get a pretty good amount of years out of him. Especially, I think next year he'll finally be ready to take the starter mantle. But honestly, I don't think Jonathan Quick is really finished. Now, like I said, I think that Peterson is the starter next year. I think it is time to go with him in net. But Quick, from what I could see, despite approaching 37, he looks like he's still got a couple years left in him. I think he'll be a fine spell option. Like, you could maybe, honestly, I know it's not traditional, but you could run Peterson like 45, maybe 50 games, and then have Quick do like the extra 32 games, maybe a little bit more. You have a great goaltending tandem in Los Angeles, and I think that's something that they absolutely need to help make this rebuild feel complete. As for what they should do with this past offseason, this next offseason, I should say, I honestly think they should do the right thing and just stay the course. Maybe make some minor moves to supplement the depth. Obviously, you're going to want to find a way on how to try to fill the hole left by Dustin Brown as he now retires. But at the same time, I don't think one thing the Kings should do is go out and just start buying like crazy. That's a mistake I've seen a lot of teams make. They have a surprising surge into the playoffs. Their window swings open a little faster than people anticipated. and in an effort to try to cash in, they go absolutely nuts and they go crazy and buy it in. I saw San Jose do it. We saw Anaheim do it. I think you could argue we saw Dallas attempt and try to, you know, push that market. We even saw Nashville try to do it. They had that crazy cup run, and then they went big game hunting just trying to get big star after big star, and they never made it back to the cup final. In my opinion, they should do, I know I'm going to sound biased, but they should do what Colorado is doing. Let the core develop on their pace, let the coaching staff do their jobs, and make supplemental moves to slowly but surely add to the core. Like when Colorado made that playoff appearance in 2017-18 after the nightmare season that they had, they didn't just go out and start buying like crazy right away. They actually ended up adding some depth with guys like Ian Cole, Matt Nieto, and Colin Wilson. Minor moves, but moves that did add forward depth. And then the Avs slowly started making more additions like Nazem Kadri, Andrei Burakovsky, Matt Calvert, Valeri Nichushkin. They slowly but surely added more depth, and then they made the big game moves. Then they went for Brandon Saad. Then they went for Devon Taves. And I think that's the path that LA should do. For now, just supplement the depth with nice little pieces to also make sure that the prospects don't get rushed into roles that they're not ready for. You have a core starting to develop. Don't rush it. Let the thing stay the course. If they go crazy buying in free agency, they run the risk of possibly messing up this team's identity and chemistry before it even has a chance to get off the ground. This rebuild has taken massive strides, and LA should be very proud. I think the regime should also take a lot of pride. I did not think they were going to be that good this quickly, so the fact that the Kings are already at a stage where they can think about building a playoff team and bolstering their lineup should be a huge sign of success. Regardless of how this year ended, regardless of how disappointing the playoffs may have ended, this was a successful campaign for the LA Kings. They absolutely knocked it out of the park, and I think that if they just stay the course and don't rush anything, the Kings could definitely find themselves back into the contending status in the next 3 to 4 years. Maybe even quicker than that if they can do this correctly. That's just my opinion on the LA Kings. I'm excited to see what they do in the future. The Western Conference looks to be very stacked in the near future. Unfortunately, now next I will be talking about teams like Boston and Pittsburgh, which do not seem to have as bright a window as the LA Kings do. But that's just my opinion. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'll be back with more videos soon. Anyways, that's it for me. I'll see you guys later.